Let somebody shout hallelujah. Shall we pray? Our Father in heaven, we want to thank you. Among other things, we want to thank you for the gift of life. Thank you for sparing our lives to see this day and to be a partaker of another edition of the moment of truth. On a special note, Lord, I want to thank you for this edition. It's a very important one because this is 58th edition of this program. I want to thank you for the past 49 editions of this program. Thank you for divine ability and enablement. Thank you for every soul that you have blessed in the past 49 editions of the Moment of Truth. And I thank you for this 58th edition, Lord. Accept our times in the mighty name of Jesus, being a landmark edition. We pray, O God, that through this message today, you will do new things in my life, in the life of everyone listening to us now, in every nation of the world, in the mighty name of Jesus. And I pray, God, that by the end of this message, our life will change completely for the better, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Almighty Father. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen and amen. Once again, I want to welcome you into another edition of the Moment of Truth. In the name of God the Father, and God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, you are welcome. In the mighty name of Jesus, this is a landmark edition, number 50 edition of the Moment of Truth. And I pray that today the Lord will give somebody a landmark blessing and special testimony. If you are the one, shout amen loud and clear wherever you are hearing us now. In the mighty name of Jesus. The theme of our message today is Embargoes Shall Be Lifted, Part 1. Embargoes Shall Be Lifted, Part 1. We are going to go through the principal text. We are going to read two passages in the Bible. The first one, 2 Kings chapter 2. Verses 19 to 22. 2 Kings chapter 2, verses 19 to 22. The second one, 2 Kings chapter 6, verses 24 to 25. 2 Kings chapter 6, verse 24 to 25. And we start from the first text, which is 2 Kings chapter 2, verses 19 to 22. I read, "And the men of the city said unto Elisha, Behold, I pray thee, the situation of this city is pleasant, as my Lord seeth, but the water is not, and the ground barren. And he said, Bring me a new cruse, and put salt therein. And they brought it to him. And he went forth unto the spring of the waters, and cast the salt in there, and said, Thus said the Lord, Have healed these waters, there shall not be from thence any more dead or barren land. So the waters were healed unto this day, according to the saying of Elisha, which he spake." The second reading, 2 Kings chapter 6, verses 24 to 25. "And it came to pass after this, that Ben-Hadad, king of Syria, gathered all his host and went up and besieged Samaria. And there was a great famine in Samaria. And behold, they besieged it until an ass head was sold for 4 pieces of silver and the 4 part of a cap of those dung for 5 pieces of silver. May we never experience such a situation like this in our life and in our nations around the globe, in the mighty name of Jesus. In the first passage, that is 2 Kings chapter 2, verses 19 to 22, we can see an embargo placed on the city of Jericho. The city was beautifully located, pleasantly located, but then there was an embargo. The land was barren. When you plant any seed inside the land, it will not germinate. If at all it germinates, it will dry up. It can never grow to become a fruit-bearing tree. Of course, the water was bitter. It was poisonous. If any pregnant woman should drink out of the water, the pregnancy will be aborted. It will be miscarried. It will come down. Even though if animal, a pregnant animal, should drink out of the water, now the animal will also suffer miscarriage. So it was a form of embargo. A form of embargo that was placed on the land. You will remember when the children of Israel, under the leadership of Joshua, conquered the city of Jericho, this man of God placed a curse on that city. And that curse placed an embargo on the city. But that day, God used another man of God, Elisha, to remove the embargo. I decree today into your life, maybe an embargo has been placed upon your life as a result of one cause or the other. I decree today in the name that is above every other name, let the embargo be removed now out of your life. Let the embargo be lifted in the mighty name of Jesus. In the second reading, we can see a pathetic situation. In the city of Samaria, the king of Syria besieged Samaria and they could not go out. Nobody can go out. Nobody could come in until there was a famine in the city of Samaria. That was another embargo. They cannot go out. They cannot come in. They cannot do their farm work. They can't do anything. They just remain indoor. It is a form of embargo. The same way, this is what we are experiencing today in the nations of the world. There is an embargo placed by coronavirus. Many people all over the nations of the world could not go to the office place. They could not go to their business place. They could not go even to the worship centers, to churches. They remain inside. It is a form of embargo. But today, as my God liveth and as his spirit liveth, I decree an end to this COVID-19, to this embargo brought to the nations of the world by coronavirus in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, what is embargo? What is embargo? Literally, embargo is official suspension of importation or exportation of certain goods to or from a country. Embargo literally is an official suspension of both importation and exportation to or from a country. When embargo is placed on a good or a product that good can never be exported outside the country or imported into the country. When you place embargo on employment, that is, nobody can be employed. When you place embargo on political activities, it means that no political activity can take place until the embargo is lifted. When embargo is placed upon any man, upon any person, that person will not be able to rise until the embargo is lifted. May I pray for somebody today? Every embargo placed upon your life, maybe upon your finances, maybe upon your marriage, maybe upon your business, maybe upon your ministry, I decree today, let the embargo be lifted now in the mighty name of Jesus. You better say a loud and clear amen to that. Now, we are not talking of embargo on the natural, we are talking about embargo in the realm of the spirit. So what is embargo in the realm of the spirit? In the realm of the spirit, embargo is a ceiling placed on someone or something not to rise. A ceiling placed upon someone or somebody not to rise. That is embargo. In the realm of the spirit, embargo can be defined as follows. Number one, embargo is a non-rising order. A non-rising order. This is an order or a power that works against the rising of people. The power that works against the lifting of the people. It is the power that will make somebody to remain in the same spot or on the same spot for many years. It is the power that sits on the promotion or advancement or lifting of people. That is why you see some people 10 years, 15 years, they are still occupying the same position. They are not promoted. Why? Because there is an embargo placed upon their lifting. The embargo, the non-rising embargo, is that type of embargo that ties our life and our destiny down to the valley of life. This type of embargo, the non-rising embargo, is the power that make us to struggle for many years without any meaningful success. In John chapter 5, verses 1 to 9, in John chapter 5, verses 1 to 9, we can see somebody for 38 years, that sick person at the pool of Bethesda for 38 years. He was on a particular spot. He could not move forward to be healed. He could not move far to be healed. He could not enter into the pool of water. Anytime angels come to trouble the water, he remained there for complete 38 years. That was a form of an embargo. If you are on the same point for many years, you could not move forward, you could not rise. That is a non-rising embargo. I pray for somebody today that is under this type of embargo. The Lord himself will have mercy on you, and that power that ties your life, your destiny, your marriage, your promotion to a particular spot for many years, I decide a part today in the mighty name of Jesus. You better say a louder amen. This embargo is the power that say, stay where you are. Is the power that say, stay where you are. Is the power that say, stay where you are. I pray today for somebody. The Lord himself, we have mercy on you in the mighty name of Jesus. In Genesis chapter 49, verses 3 to 4. Genesis chapter 49, verses 3 to 4. We can see the story of somebody, Reuben. He was the firstborn of Jacob, but then his father, shortly before he died, placed an embargo upon him. It is a non-rising embargo. We are going to read it together. Genesis chapter 49, verses 3 to 4. Reuben, thou art my firstborn, my might, and the beginning of my strength, the excellence of dignity, and the excellence of power. Unstable as water, thou shalt not exist, because thou wentest up to thy father's bed, then defiedest thou it. He went up to my couch. Can we see? Reuben slept with his father many years back, and his father pretended as if he doesn't know. But this day, the father just called him and placed a curse, placed an embargo upon his life. He said, Reuben, you will not exist. That is an embargo, a non-rising embargo. I pray for somebody today that is under this type of embargo. The Lord will have mercy on you, and you shall be free for that embargo in the mighty name of Jesus. You better say a loud and clear amen. In some families, they don't rise. There is a power that presses them down. And remember the story of somebody, the father of a man of God. He told us the story many, many years ago. In the family that produced this man of God, everybody in that family, they don't rise. They can struggle and struggle for many years, but they will never, never rise. And this thing also affected his own father. When it was time for them to be employed into the civil service, in those days, when you have premises certificate, they let the primary school leaving certificate, they call it Standard 6 in Nigeria in those days. Standard 6 certificate. When you enter into the public service with your Standard 6, you'll be undergoing what they call in-service training, and you'll be earning your promotion until you will retire as permanent secretary. So this man, the father of this our pastor, also enter into service with Standard 6 along with his friends. Don't forget, he came from a family where they don't prosper, where they don't rise. That is a form of an embargo. Now he enter, all his friends, they apply for the post of a clerical officer. But this man applied for the post of a driver, and they told him, apply for the post of clerical officer. He said, no, I want to apply for the post of a driver. I love that position. It was not his fault. It was a power that worked against him. To cut the story short, all his friends enter into the service, they end their promotion, to in service training, and they retired one by one as permanent secretary. But for this man, he entered as driver and retired as driver. A time came, he became driver to his mate that entered the service with him the same day and with the same qualification. His friends retired as permanent secretary, but then he retired as a servant. to his mate. He enter as driver, he retire as driver. His mate enter as cleric officer and they retire as a permanent secretary. We can see people of God that embargo is not good because embargo prevented him from rising, because in this other family, nobody has risen to the top before. Now, I pray for somebody that the Lord will have mercy on you. If you come from such a family, I decree today, I destroy every embargo of such from your life in the mighty name of Jesus. But then good news is that our pastor happened to be the first person that God himself lifted in that family. Because at a point in time in his life, he knew Jesus. He surrendered himself to Jesus Christ, and the Lord took over and saved him and delivered him from that embargo. So today, if you are hearing me from any place across the globe, let me tell you, the first step to be free from this type of embargo is to come to Jesus, and he will save you. He will deliver you from that embargo, and you will rise again. I pray today, as you do so, you will rise again in the mighty name of Jesus. Number two, what is embargo? Embargo is a limitational order. Don't forget, number one, embargo is a non-rising order. Number two now, embargo is a limitational order. This is the power that limits our rising to a particular level. Under the non-rising embargo, you will not rise at all. But under the limitational embargo, you will rise to a particular level. After that level, it will be difficult for you to rise beyond that level. And the plan of God for you, according to Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 13, is to be the head, to rise to the top. But when you are under limitational embargo, you will rise to a particular average level. After that place, you will struggle to get over and above that level. It will be possible. You may be a public servant. You may have the credentials to rise to the top. But then, if you are under limitational embargo, you will rise to an average level. After that, they will not promote you again. I pray for somebody today who is under this type of embargo, limitation embargo. The Almighty God will have mercy on you, and the embargo will be destroyed in the mighty name of Jesus. For example, maybe a woman that is ordained by God to have 4 children. At the end of the day, she was able to have only 1 child. You cannot call her a barren woman, but at the same time, she is not able to get to that point of becoming the mother of 4 children. She had only 1 child. After that child, there was a ceiling placed on his ability to bear children. That is limitational embargo, limitational power. Limit a child bearing to only 1 child as against 4 children. For example, again, maybe God ordained somebody to be a landlord, house owner, an estate owner, an estate owner, but you end up in life being a landlord over a bungalow of 3 rooms. Yes, you are a landlord, you are an house owner, but then the purpose of God for you is beyond a 3-bedroom apartment, is to be an owner of an estate. But if you are under limitational embargo, that power will limit you to becoming the landlord of 3-bedroom flat as against becoming the owner of an estate. I pray for somebody today, the power that limits your rising, that limits your lifting to a particular undesirable level. That power is destroyed today in the mighty name of Jesus. The plan of God for us is to grow every day in every facet of life, to continue to grow. But limitation embargo will not allow you to grow to the top. In 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 18, 2 Peter 3, 18, the Bible says, but grow in grace and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. To him be the glory both now and forever. Amen. He said, grow in grace. So the Almighty God wants us to grow in every facet of life to the highest point in life. But limitation embargo will not allow you to grow beyond a particular undesirable level. Once again, I destroy such a power from your life today in the mighty name of Jesus. You will reach the top. Your head will reach the top in the mighty name of Jesus. Number three, what is embargo? Embargo is a non-progressive order. A non-progressive order. That is an instruction, a demonic instruction not to move forward, not to progress, not to break through, not to prosper in life. I love a phrase in the Bible. In 1 Samuel chapter 10, verse 3a. 1 Samuel chapter 10, verse 3a. I love this phrase. It says, thou shall move forward. I pray for somebody today, thou shall move forward in the mighty name of Jesus. I repeat again, thou shall move forward in the mighty name of Jesus. I repeat for the third time, thou shall move forward in the mighty name of Jesus. You better say a louder amen. Join me to sing this song. I'm pressing on the upward way. New item gain. Every day. Still praying as I overband. Band. Lord plant my feet on higher ground. Lord lift me up and let me stand. By faith on heaven's table land, where Lord I plan, and love and bind, Lord plant my feet on higher ground. I pray for somebody today, the Lord will plant your feet on higher ground. You will move forward, you will progress in the mighty name of Jesus. There are four types of movement I need to share with us briefly. Four types of movement. We are talking of embargo, a non-progressive power, a non-progressive order. Four types of movement. Number one, there is movement round a circle. Some people, they move round a circle, day in, day out, year in, year out. Where they started 3 years ago, it is where they are now. They just move, they move, they move, come back to where they started from. They are moving, they are walking, but they are not making any progress. They move around the circle, year in, year out. They can never point to any meaningful achievement. That is moving around the circle. It is a movement under non-progressive embargo. Number two, there is backward movement, backward movement. In this one, they go backward every day and every time. They are the people that witness what we call a better yesterday. That is, their lives in every aspect. Yesterday is far, far better than their life today. It is a serious embargo. I pray for somebody today. You will never witness a better yesterday in your life. You will never go back in the mighty name of Jesus. Your movement in life will never be backward one in the mighty name of Jesus. Number three, we have the counterproductive movement. Counterproductive movement. This one is one step forward, two step backward. They make one progress in life, but then something will happen that will erode that progress, and then they will move backward. One progress and follow with two failures, two calamities. They have one success. After that one success, they experience multiple failure. That is counterproductive movement. One step forward and then two step backward. It's not your portion in Jesus' name. If you are under this type of embargo today, I decree freedom for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Number three, progressive movement. I love this one. This is a movement that we keep you moving forward, progressing, success from success to success. You move from glory to glory, from power to power, from victory to victory. This is a progressive movement. I pray for somebody today. This will be your portion in the mighty name of Jesus. Number four, embargo is a non-performance order. A non-performance order. This is an instruction for something in your life to cease to perform. It's an instruction for something in your life not to perform its expected duty. For example, it's an order on your certificate not to fetch you a good job. It's an order on your manhood not to be able to produce children. It's an order on your womb not to bring forth children. It's an order on your life not to be productive. It's a non-performance order. I pray for somebody today that is suffering under this type of embargo. The Lord will deliver you in the mighty name of Jesus. You better say a louder amen. This type of embargo will make your gift and your talent to die. You are gifted, you are talented, but then that gift and talent is not even manifesting. It's there within you. It is an embargo. I pray today, everything in your life that had not been performing before, I decree today life unto those things in the mighty name of Jesus. I remember a testimony of a brother that came to one of our programs many years ago. We called the program Fire Must Change Life. We instructed them to pray and to pray. We pray on their hands and we told them, go back home. Anything that is not working in your life, when you get back home, place your hand on that thing and pray. And that thing will start to work. Before this one, the man was running a business center. All his computer, the enemy just struck. All the computer he was using, at the same time, developing faults. And they try to repair it. The technicians could not even repair it. They try. It was non, they became non-repairable. But this brother, after leaving the program, he went to his business center. One by one, he placed his hand on the computer. To God's own glory, they started working. The computer started to perform. I pray for you today. In the same way, wherever you are now, just point your hand towards my direction. Point your hands towards my direction. I decree into these hands, in the name that is above every name, the anointing for performance. Receive now in the mighty name of Jesus. I release anointing for performance on these hands now. I release anointing for performance on these hands now. I release anointing for performance on these hands now. In the mighty name of Jesus. When you get back home, even right now, you place the hands on your head and you decree beautiful things, positive things into your life. Bless your life for a new beginning. Bless your life for a new beginning. And when you get back home, anything that is not performing in your life, is it your certificate or the womb of your wife or the brain of your child? Just place your hand on those parts of your body that is not performing, or that of your wife or children, or any property of yours. Place the hands and decree to them that they receive life. And your testimony will resound in the mighty name of Jesus. On the final note, embargo number 5 is a rescission order. Rescission order. That is ability to see and not to have. Moses was a man that suffered this type of embargo after a labor for many years. Just little time for him to enter into Canaan. God told him, look at the Canaan land you labor for 40 years. You will see it with your hands, but then you never enter into it. That is a rescission order, a rescission embargo. It was restricted from entering into the land of Canaan. We can see that one in Deuteronomy chapter 34, verse 4. Deuteronomy 34, 4. And the Lord said unto him, this is the land which I swear unto Abraham, unto Isaac, and unto Jacob, saying, I will give it unto thy seed. I have caused thee to see it with thy eyes, but thou shalt not go over thither. God told Moses, I have caused you to see the land you labor for 40 years, but you never enter into it. It was an embargo, and his life and the ministry ended on that point. I pray for you. You will never be placed under this type of embargo in the mighty name of Jesus. This type of embargo will make you to live and then not to affect. It's a negative authority that prevents people from reaping where they have sowed, from celebrating where they labor. It will prevent them from reaping the fruit of their labor. It is the power behind what you call near success syndrome. You see success coming your way, but in a jiffy, the whole thing will just disappear. A situation will arise that will make the whole thing to disappear. I remember the story of a sister. She was to be given a lucrative job in the Federal Capital Territory of Nigeria, Abuja. She went for the interview. She passed the interview. She went back home. The following week, she went for the letter of employment. But they told her, sorry, the position had been suspended. Up to today, they never gave her that position until she came to Jesus. And then we pray, and the Lord bless her with a better thing. She saw the employment coming away. She started rejoicing, but the embargo worked against her. I pray for somebody today, every embargo that will make you to see joy and not having joy, I destroy it out of your life today in the mighty name of Jesus. This embargo will make you to labor only for that to reap. That is embargo. This embargo will make you to fail where others are succeeding. I destroy this embargo out of your life today in the mighty name of Jesus. You better say a louder amen. Now, the next thing for us is to pray. But before we pray, I told you something, that the Lord himself is able to destroy embargo for your life, but then something can work against it. That is your sin. In case you are hearing me now, you still commit sin. Bow down your head and confess your sin to God. Tell him, I am a sinner. I am a sinner. I have no excuse. Comprehensively, I am a sinner. But then, forgive me. Forgive me my sins. Erase your sin. Erase my sin with the blood of Jesus, your son, and then give me the grace to go and sin no more. Write my name in the book of life. Just pray. Tell God, I am a sinner, but today I repent of my sin. Forgive my sin in the mighty name of Jesus. And the Lord Almighty God will forgive you your sin in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Now, finally, It's time for us to pray against embargo. We have 7 prayer points, and I want you to get me to pray the prayer. We always pray in the name of Jesus. Please pray this prayer aggressively with your power and everything within you. Prayer number one, shout in the name of Jesus and declare every power from my parents' house working against my rising. Die, die, die. Every power from my parents' house working against my rising. Die, die, die. In the name of Jesus, every power from my parents' house working against my rising, die, die, die. In the name of Jesus, in Jesus' name, we have prayed. Prayer number two, shout in the name of Jesus and decree every evil declaration against my rising. Be nullified by fire. Every evil declaration against my rising, be nullified by fire. In the mighty name of Jesus, every evil declaration against my rising, be nullified by fire in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Number three, prayer number three. Shout in the name of Jesus and decree as follows. Every negative force limiting my rising to a particular point in life, be destroyed by fire. Every negative force limiting my rising to a particular point in life, be destroyed by fire. Let us pray. In the name of Jesus, every negative force limiting my rising to a particular point in life, be destroyed by fire. Every negative force limiting my rising to a particular point in life, be destroyed by fire. Every negative force limiting my rising to a particular point in life, be destroyed by fire. In the mighty name of Jesus, in Jesus' name, we have prayed. Prayer number four, shout in the name of Jesus and say, every backward and retrogressive spirit attacking my onward and progressive movement in life, what are you waiting for? Be paralyzed by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Every backward and retrogressive spirit attacking my onward and progressive movement in life, what are you waiting for? Be paralyzed by fire. Every backward and retrogressive spirit attacking my onward movement, onward and progressive movement in life, what are you waiting for? Be paralyzed by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Every backward and retrogressive spirit attacking my onward and progressive movement in life, what are you waiting for? Be paralyzed by fire in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Prayer number five. Shout in the name of Jesus and say, every counterproductive power militating against my rising and elevation in life, what are you waiting for? Die, die, die. Every counterproductive power militating against my rising and elevation in life, what are you waiting for? Die, die, die. Just pray, pray, pray. In the name of Jesus, every counterproductive power militating against my rising and elevation in life, what are you waiting for? Die, die, die. In the name of Jesus. Prayer number six, every agent of non-performance assigned to torment my destiny, what are you waiting for? Die, die, die. In the name of Jesus. Every agent of non-performance assigned to torment my life and destiny, what are you waiting for? Die, die, die. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we have prayed finally. Prayer number seven, shout in the name of Jesus and say, every anti-breakthrough and near success power commission against my greatness in life, what are you waiting for? Die, die, die. In the name of Jesus, every anti-breakthrough and near success power commission against my greatness in life, what are you waiting for? Die, die, die. In the name of Jesus, in Jesus' name, we have prayed and I decree today, the Almighty God that answered by fire, we answer all these prayer requests from number 1 to number 7 by fire and grace our testimonies of freedom from embargoes be in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Almighty Father. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen and amen. Once again, God bless you for coming. Join us next week again. In the Lord tarries, in the mighty name of Jesus. Once again, let somebody shout a great hallelujah.